Here's another sample problem for normal stress. Here we have a combination of a hollow shaft connected to a solid rod. So the hollow shaft is from point A to B, and then the solid rod is from point B to C. You also have external forces. So we have tension force here, 8 kilonewton at point C. And then you have a compressive force at point A, and then you have compressive forces at point B, 6 kilonewton. And then we're actually asked here to find the normal stress at point D, this section, and point E, which is at this section. Also given are the diameters for the inner and outer diameters of the hollow shaft. We have 20 mm and 28 millimeters, and the diameter of the solid rod, which is 12 millimeters. So again, the required are the normal stresses at point D and point E, somewhere in the section between the A and B and between B and C. So again, for solution, our working equations for stress is this one. Sigma is just equal to force over area. So for D, we have the force D and then force area D. So how do we find the force D? We just have to cut section. We have to cut this section. We'll call this section DD. So at section DD, we have this one. We have a 4 kilonewton. If you remember this one from your statics of rigid bodies, the method of sections. And then you have a reaction force, internal force, which is now your PD, which is your force at the section D. So we have summation of forces along X equals 0. So you just have PD equals 4 kilonewton. So your stress D is just equal to 4,000 newton. This is just 4 kilonewton divided by the area. Now since the section D is at the shaft, the hollow shaft, you have the area equals pi over 4 D outer minus D inner. So you have 28 square minus 20 square, stress D equals 13.3 megapascals. If you want to again be refreshed on this, we discussed this in another example, but basically it's just came from the pi over 4. We have the area outer d2 squared minus the pi over 4 d1 squared, and then you have the common term here, pi over 4. You just have to take that out, and then you have to retain the two given diameters. If you're confused with the pi over 4, comes from the pi r squared, and then you know that r is just d over 2. So when you square this one, you also square this one, you'll have d squared over 4. So that's why you have the pi over 4. So just have to review. For stress at E, you have to cut section. So again, to make this simpler, we cut at this section. We'll call this EE. So, and we consider the right side, of the section. At section EE, we have this one, tensile force of 8 kilonewton. And then, of course, the reaction, the internal force, is also directed the opposite direction. We have the PE. So same with the previous computation, the reaction or the reaction force is always on the opposite direction of your external force. So same with here. So again, summation of forces along the x-axis equals 0. We have PE, which is equal to 8 kilonewton. And then you have the stress at E, it's just equal to 8,000 newton, divided by, now, because point E is the section at the solid rod. We only have single diameter, so pi over 4 times your diameter, which is 12 mm square. Your stress E is equal to 70.7 megapascals. Okay, so again, this is megapascals, Newton per mm square. That's megapascals. And the directions, we have the stress D. If you can observe in this drawing, it's a compressive stress. And the stress E is, you can observe from this drawing, it's directed away its attention. So there we have the answers for stress D and stress E. And you just have to choose which sides of the sections are you going to analyze. So you will have more convenient or easier computation of the internal forces. You can also consider the left side portion, but we'll have more forces. We'll have to deal with more forces. Now we'll deal with this one, and then you have too many forces to deal with. So we always choose the advise you to choose always the section or the part where you have to work with lesser variables or lesser items.